All right, in the Rocky Mountain West, the tags are limited. So to be fair, they have point systems in most of the Western states that will allow you to eventually draw a tag. Some states, for instance, New Mexico, Idaho, don't have a preference point system. They go, or a bonus point system. They go strictly with lottery. You're either in or out. You either draw or you don't. Other states have preference points. Other states have bonus points. And some states have both. Some have a hybrid of both. Preference points is, a preference point will give you preference. Whoever has the most points will get the tag. So someone with 15 points will draw before anyone with 14 points. And someone with 10 and lower won't have a chance in that unit. But some states will have, they'll have many units. Some units may not have a high success rate, or maybe there's not as much public land. And maybe you might only need a couple preference points to draw that unit. While the hardest sought after units will usually take more preference points. Bonus points are the lottery. More or less, you buy a ticket, you put it in the lottery, they spin the wheel, and they pull out some tickets. With the bonus point, for every bonus point you have, you get another ticket in the lottery. So if you have 10 bonus points, you get put in for 10 plus this year's license. So that's 11 chances to draw that tag. So it does increase your odds, but it doesn't guarantee it like preference point. And like a state, Montana does a squaring. So Montana does non-resident preference points for elk tags and so forth when it comes to the general tag, the combo license. But for everything else, we pretty much do a bonus point system, but we square it. So if you have 3 bonus points, that you go in 9 times. If you have 4 bonus points, you go in 16 times, 25 times and up, you know. It really increases your chance of drawing a tag. So as you can see, hunting the West is not an immediate thing. You have to plan. You cannot walk and get an over-the-counter elk tag or deer tag in most of our states. You have to plan. Put in for the application each year and try and build those points up. You can earn a point a year per species. And many, many hunters that are real serious about it will be in multiple states and they're applying for different species in multiple states. It's pretty neat. And they'll eventually have some wonderful hunts. Some states like New Mexico, they have landowner tags where you can actually go buy it from the rancher, from the landowner. And you don't have to play the system at all. You just go buy it. But they're quite a few thousands of dollars as a rule. And there's other states that also have landowner tags that you could buy. But doing the general tag, if you're just going to do it the least expensive route, you do the point system. And every website of every state will explain their system. You eventually should draw the tag of your life. So